piece right now, and the piece is titled Futility 2022. And yeah, thanks for coming out.
Web Henry with precision, few herbs and a bit of Benson. But don't forget the Rizzler. Lean like the Tower of Pisa. These are Oasia. And this is a day in the...
Describe a particularly fond memory from your childhood. How about you, Jack?
Well, I came from
there's plenty more where that came from.
nuclear family, but my mother is from a large Irish Catholic family from central Minnesota. So I grew up with a lot of cousins who were my closest friends growing up. And so growing up, knock it off. We went camping every year in central Minnesota. My mother and her brothers and sisters would organize a kind of event where everybody would gather and set up their tents. And I think back very fondly on those times where I would hang out with my cousin Abe and my cousin Daniel, who were both around my age. We would go swimming, we would get to stay up late around the fire, cook marshmallows, and it was, I think back on it very fondly, you know, and of course everybody, we grow up and you sort of age out of these kind of things, but so probably by the time I was, you know, pubescent or adolescent, I think we kind of stopped doing that. But, so, yeah, so It's a nice memory I have. Anyways, next section, please.
Full Metal Alchemist!
My favorite swear word is bollocks.
Bunch of cold souls, he's known as the Globetrotter. Lonely road guy, he knows his grown father. From home, he's no father. He goes home and barely knows his own daughter. But hold your nose, cause here goes the cold water.
Create a universal law for music that would be enforced and lawbreakers punished, what would it be? How about you, Jeff?
So there's obviously no rules in music or laws. Clearly, that's why we can do this. But we've done
everything we can do.
Clairement, for the sake of this piece, I guess we would say that we would outlaw the use of digital delay and processing sound. The idea would be that, you know, you've spent a lot of time thinking of a sound and coming up with a sound, and
you look like a stuffed baby.
You don't need to then repeat the sound over and over and over and over again. The first time you present it,
it's probably the best.
But that's just a hypothetical rule. We don't have to put that into place. Next section, please.
Ma questa è solo una regola.
Thank you.
the last person you argued with, and what was the argument about? How about you, Jack?
The last person that I argued with was the security agent at Amsterdam Schiphol Airport. We were very late to catch the flight, so we had to skip the line. That was okay, a little stressful. But as we got through the security line, we were very close to missing our flight. But of course,
reluctantly crouched at the start.
Both of our bags got pulled aside. We're rushing. What do we do? We're going to miss the flight. And the guy says, "All right, we got to check your bag." And he says, "Listen, man, we have to catch this flight." And he said, "You know what? Hey, chill out, man. Chill out." And I said, "Okay, listen, you know, just we have to make this flight." And he said, "You have to calm down, sir." And he sent one of his.
You're getting nervous, man. Calm down. It's okay.
And he, his colleague said, "Sir, is everything okay? Please settle down." And so, knock it off. And so he goes through my bag, you know, and I'm like, "Come on, man." He dumps everything out of my bag. And
everything we can do.
And I'm like, "What the fuck are you doing?" And so he then puts it back and says, "You know what? Are you happy?"
What are you doing? I said,
from the ads? If you tap now to watch a short video, you'll receive 30 minutes of ad-free music.
How many shrimps do you have to eat?
Sometimes I feel like I
What up, baby?
Control me. Y'all can't control me. Y'all don't understand that I'm turnt all the way. I believe in me. Just believe in you. Let me do me. You like it? Cool. You don't? Fast forward.
Somebody. Don't care. Plus, they're
mad. I am serious. And don't call me Shirley.
What you know about rolling down in the
List as many of your favorite songs as you can. How about you, Jack?
Stairway to Heaven, Clocks by Coldplay, Bittersweet Symphony, Step On, Happy Mondays, let's see, Wonderwall by Oasis, Hot in Here by Snoop Dogg, Don't Stop Believin', Big Papa by Biggie Small. Let's see, Back in Black by AC/DC.
Let's go, I'm bored.
I know, I'm working on it. What other songs do I love? Jeez, there's a lot of songs that I like. What about like the Turkish March by Mozart? That's pretty good. How about, let's are some other good ones? I'm really drawing a blank here. What about Crazy in Love by, you know, Beyonce? Oh, maybe that one doesn't work so well. Let's see. Can I think of one more song, maybe? That's probably...
Describe in detail a particularly unpleasant memory you have of touring as a musician. How about anyone from the audience? Anybody?
Anybody?
Anybody want to come to the mic? Anybody? 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 Anybody?
Anybody? Anybody?
Okay, I can just take
N'importe
this
quel.
I've had many unpleasant memories
D'accord.
touring as a
Je
musician.
Peux juste prendre celui-ci.
A really bad one was one time I was playing in Texas and...
right now, you're really playing the victim.
At the back of the room. And as I was playing, I noticed a person start
Ein
to
wirklich schlechtes war
leave
eine,
the crowd and approach
ich
me.
Habe in Texas gespielt und das Publikum war hinten
and everyone became focused on this person who was walking up to me. And the person came right up here, right in front of where I was playing.
There's plenty more where that came from.
They turned around so their back was facing me. And they pulled their pants down. And they just started mooning me. They were just shaking their bare ass at me while I was playing music. Yeah, it was pretty embarrassing. I think that's what they thought of the music.
Great success.
I wish you
step back from that ledge, my friend. You could cut ties with all the lies that you've been living in. And if you do not want to see me again, I would understand. I would understand.
What are some current problems with experimental music? How about anyone from the audience? Anybody?
I think I know how this is gonna go.
Anybody?
I think some problems with experimental music today. Knock it off, we heard you. Come on. I think big problem with it is both the lack of rigor in the construction and production of it, but simultaneously the lack of levity in how it is presented and also perceived. I think that they go hand in hand, even if they might seem slightly contradictory, but people need to lighten the fuck up and make better music.
That's this. This is me.
This is how we do it.
Wait away, boy. You wait away, boy. Wait away, boy. Wait away, boy. Wait away, boy.
One thing it is okay to lie about. How about anyone from the audience? Anybody?
Anybody?
Okay, so you can definitely lie to your boss or your employer. That's perfectly fine.
You can lie to their family when they ask how your life is going.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine.
Knock it off. You probably don't want to lie to your friends.
There's something you don't want to do, but you gotta do it.
Help me!
Google what classifies music as good and read a definition out loud. How about anyone from the audience? Anybody? Anybody? Anybody?
Anybody?
It's randomized, I swear. We wouldn't have been intentionally
anybody?
Asking you guys after the first time.
Anybody?
All right. So, bad music is a phrase I mostly use in a subjective sense, my own opinion. For example, I really hate Rush, but I'm not going to be some sort of douche that goes around.
We're living in the temporary autonomous zone. New meaning assigned to old media. We take the retro with the underground into online influence, and then we're getting an influx of world culture. Broadcasting, information, saturation, overloaded, paralyzed. The future coming forward, the ego pushing backward, it feels I'm looking inward for the image of my will. Do you and I even know each other anymore, once I've been reduced to a fragment? Or once I've been reduced to newspapers, cycling through feeds of what we're cooking or how far we've gone, avatars of our pets occupying the kitchen space of RGB, becoming novelties, becoming characters, symbols, representations of ourselves, commodified for our own practical purposes. But it's all the individual, through the desire of residual, that's all the time. It's a fear of death, or just mainstream influence out of touch with what it means for us to live. As we're staying still and getting more, we're growing so much more than we have anything to give. In the first world, my pain is not hunger, it's purpose, the lack of hunger makes.
Hello, this is Matthew's mother and legal guardian. You will desist in contacting my son and having any more irrational and upsetting arguments. That is a form of cyberbullying. You will be blocked and reported to Instagram. This is your only warning.
Describe one thing about you that others might find annoying. How about you, Jack?
I have been told that I have a very loud voice.
I won't do what you tell me!
How would your friends describe your music? How about you, Jeff?
I think they would probably say we're delusional.
Thank you for workshopping this piece with us.